Hi everybody, not since Eurovision 2022 have we seen this young man, but it's Achille Lelaura, Che Sera, which means what will be. It's new music since Eurovision. He finished ninth in Turin this year and he did really, really well thereafter. A lot of interest was caused by his performance, by his persona, and just by the sheer exuberance of displaying so many tattoos and doing a bit of a swing of the hips, and it was a good uplifting song. But this is quite sober in tone, I have to say. But I've been intrigued to find out what's lying behind it, and this is the song we're going to listen to today. Achille Lelaura returns after his appearance at the Eurovision 2022 with this new single, Che Sera, What Will Be. The ballad showcases a different and more emotional side to the Italian star. But as the song builds, Lelaura's punk spirit still shines through. Achille discusses the feelings of loneliness and how he's learning to comfort himself. And certain words that are used throughout the chorus, what will be, I hug myself, how, as if I were you and it never ends, are part of the build-up to the emotional impact this song has. I'll discuss the lyrics straight after, but not until I introduce the new fans to whom this guy is about, because even though he's singing about loneliness, this is a very shrewd businessman, as you're going to learn. Achille Lelaura's stage name of Lara Di Marinas is an Italian singer, songwriter, rapper, producer originally from Rome. As he explained in an interview, his stage name is inspired by that of a ship of the same name, at the center of various news stories over the years, and in turn named after the Italian shipowner Achille Lelaura. He was born and grew up in the Roman suburbs of Val Melena, where he grew up with his older brother, who at the time already was a producer and DJ of the Quarter Block Collective. He began to take his first steps in the hip-hop world anonymously, maintaining that until the release of his first mixtape, Barabbas, in 2013. In 2014, he signed for Roshia Music, a Marrakesh label for which he released Immortal, Achille, Idol, and D.O.C. In 2016, he left Roshia Music, created his own label, No Face Agency, and released the album Ragazia Madre. In 2019, he took part in the San Remo Festival with the song Rolls Royce, finishing ninth. The song was the manifesto of this song, Rock and Wave, and that resulted in his album 1969. In 2022, he announced his appointment as creative director of the Italian division of Elektra Records, a label owned by Warner, to which he also transferred his recording activities. So now that he's part of the Warner Group, this young man's career is certainly on the way up, because just like so many other great Italian singer-songwriters, he lives in the shadow of so many other people. But I think his edginess, his look, his rock ability, the fact that he's got a punk ability and a pop ability to his songwriting skills and music is always going to give him an edge over other Italian artists, simply because you cannot put Achille Lelaura into a box and say that is his music. It's not. He varies it a lot, which is the stimulus for his success, because people are intrigued by what he's going to come out with next. So back onto today's particular track, let's listen. I won't interrupt, and I'll give you my interpretation afterward.
Grande che dà quel minuto di più. no, ho paura, mami, stringimi, non guardare giù. Che sarà? Che sarà? Che sarà? Siamo soli, ma che sarà? Mi stringo a me come, come se fossi te. Così stare al mondo e no, non è qui, non è mai stato qui, non è questo il posto per noi, quei ragazzi a vent'anni che bruciano fiammiferi, sì. Noi, quelli là che a vent'anni da soli nelle mani di chi? Noi, che moriamo soltanto perché sennò che vita è la mia. Noi che nasciamo qua giù e non sappiamo cosa la vita sia. Che sarà? Che sarà? Che sarà? Siamo soli, ma che sarà? Mi stringo a me come, come se fossi te. Così stare al mondo e no, non è qui, non è mai stato qui, no, non è questo il posto. Immagina com'è essere soli al mondo, no, a noi stanotte ci fa ridere e moriremo un giorno. Siamo soli, ma che sarà? Mi stringo a me come, come se fossi te e non finisse mai.
Right up to the very last note to hold your attention in that video. I'm going to ask a question to everybody. When was the last time you felt lonely? And I bet you a lot of people would say, this morning, the last 24 hours, whilst I was at work. That kind of thing. We all feel loneliness, either on a daily basis, an hourly basis, a weekly basis. But it hits us every couple of days. We all feel an element of loneliness in this world. So we can all relate to that video. A lot of symbolism. A lot of symbolism. To me, straight away, before I get into the lyrics and give you my interpretation, I'm going to say this. He was blindfolded. Because when you're lonely, when you feel isolated, when you feel away from everything, you're blinded to the world. You don't see anything beyond here, beyond here. Everything is in darkness around you. You become isolated. You don't want people around you. But yet we've seen him walking. And I like the way the symbolism of loneliness continued with him in the white suit. There we have Achille Lauro, almost in white, like the angelic look. With the black and white, visual of people walking around him, but he is symbolic of a lonely man in a crowd. Why does he wear this blindfold? Because he doesn't see the world. It's even the video was the sound of thunder and grayness around him. You just see, you're in a black hole, you're in a dark place. So you don't see from here to here, you don't see anything but darkness and emptiness and the feeling of coldness and isolation. You don't smile. He never once smiled during the video. It's all elements of severe loneliness and isolation from everything. And with the guy that's so shrewd in his business life and so successful in his music career now, since Eurovision has launched him into the public eye, you wonder what the song is about. I'll tell you what I feel straight away from that video, because it ended with the sound of the bells in a church, depictions on the walls, but we get that if we walk into a church, a religious building. It's almost like he's died inside. And his life will be his funeral, because we all, those, when I hear a church-like sound and the bells, I always think of funerals. So he's almost died, buried himself emotionally, and he's feeling so low and so lonely. He wonders how to get out of it. Let's see what the lyrics say and quickly go through them and see if I'm right. I'm very intrigued. It's a very solemn video, I have to say. First one, no, I'm not 20 anymore, and I know this is my life. No, I don't know if you love me. No, I don't know where mine is. We are angels, yes, with such a great God, which gives us that minute more. No, I'm scared. Mommy, hold me. Don't look down. So there's that little boy lost feeling, wanting his mother's hugs, the reassuring hugs. You're going to be all right, son. You'll be fine in life. The way mothers always nurture their children, you'll be fine. You'll get through this. But I feel, and I have to say this, and this comes from my experience with people who get tattoos all over their body, and it goes right up to his neck. And there's one or two in the face. And I hope he doesn't go any, you don't go any more than that, because you're an extraordinarily powerful looking guy, and you need to keep visual. I've seen people with tattoos all over their face here in Dublin, and they've walked by me, and I literally just go, it takes my breath away. It's almost too much. But what happens with some people is those are symbols of their life, and they get tattoos to represent elements of their life, how they feel, how they act, and it becomes a collage of messages all over their body, and they hide their insecurities behind the next part of the story or the next tattoo that says whom they are, or words that are meaningful to them, if that makes sense. And I feel over the years Kyle Lauro has done this, and he's built up a story around his body. But the song is reflecting real life almost, because even with all the people around him, even with the fame in music, it can be a lonely, lonely world. And maybe Akil Lara has not found that special person because there's too many layers to his personality. Because here he says, we are angels, yes, with such a great God, which gives that minute more. In other words, when we pray to God, we do get answers eventually to what we're seeking. And is Akil Lara, through his loneliness, looking salvation from the past? Is he looking commitment, encouragement for the future in his music career? Or is he looking the inner strength to face each day, when it's a total battle for him to get through each day? Well, let's go through the next verse, because it says, what will be, what will be, what will be, which is the title to this song. We are lonely, but what will it be? I hug me like I'm you, and it would never end. That's it, that's it. It's like being in a world, no, it's not here. Never been here. This is not the place for us. Now he mentions us and he says, I'm not like you, and he's referring to somebody. So what will be, we've all heard what in life, what will be, what will be. We've heard you come into this world crying, you leave this world crying. We hear many things. But he needs constant reassurance because he says here, I hug me like I'm you. So you almost get the impression, Akil Lara is sitting in the corner, he's hugging himself, and he's just comforting himself. We all learn at the end of the day that the only friend we have in this world is ourselves, believe it or not. The only person that we can trust is ourselves. That's why we have an instinctive nature to know, but we always never listen to ourselves. He gets reassurance going through every day in his own company. And it's almost you sense he's gotten so used to being the individual as a child who missed his mother hugs, to going through school, being different, to being in the music industry, now getting the adulation, but still feeling lonely. Because the sense of loneliness with some people never goes away. No matter how much comfort you give yourself or reassurance, I'll get through this day. He says, never been here. This is not the place for us. In other words, and is he talking about us in a love situation? I think not. I think it's spiritual. Because of all the spiritual things and the church bells at the end, there's a very spiritual nature to him. He's guided with his belief in himself, his faith in life, and he's learned to be his own boss and choose his own destiny and walk forward himself. So us, for me, is spiritual. It's his religious faith that gets him through things. He continues, those 20-year-old boys that burn matches, yes. We those there who at 20 years were alone. We were alone in whose hands? We only die because otherwise what life is mine? And we who are born here, we don't know what life is. So he goes through the stages of life, birth, death, birth, living life, and then death. That's his philosophy. Because at the very end he says, and we don't know what life is. No, we don't know what life is. We don't know what curveballs life will throw at us. We don't know what people will meet, what work situations we'll be in. We just go into life, as I said before, we come in crying and we hope to leave the world not crying and be happy and be settled and have a good life that we always hear our parents, our grandparents have. But today it's so, so difficult. There's so many emotional problems, but at least today we talk about them and mental issues. And this is very much a mental struggle he's talking about in his lyrics, that he's had to face many mental issues. But at least today we can talk about them, like me with the lyrics. And then he says, you know, over the 20 years, he's wondered whose hands is he in? Is his faith, he's testing his faith. Is it worth me putting my faith in God's hands? Is it worth putting my faith into a person? Is life even worth it? They're the questions he's asking after 20 years. And the refrain says, what will be, we're alone, what will be, I hope like me. If I were you and it would never end, that's it. It's like being in a world and no, it's not here. He's never been here. No, this isn't the place. So when he questions at the end, it's being like in the world and no, it's not here. He's never been here. Everything. And then at the end, he says, imagine how it is being alone in the world. No, to us tonight makes us laugh and we will die one day. And we will die one day. And we will laugh one day. So maybe he feels all the struggles in life, all that he's been through, all the loneliness, the only peace and the only sense of relief and smile he'll get is when he dies. And that's why I think we come into, towards the end of the video, the symbolism of the church, the sound of the bells, and that eeriness feeling there's a funeral taking place. And the outro is, what will be, we're alone, what will be. I hug me like I'm you, and it never ends. So he reassures himself in his faith. He reassures he'll get through another day. But the struggle to do that, the loneliness he feels, even surrounded by people who take pictures and are in awe of him musically, he's still a lonely person finding his way in life. A lot of people are, Arcaio Lara, and that'll resonate with a lot of people. The only thing I can say to everybody is, if you're suffering loneliness, there's lots of organizations out there that will help you. Find somebody you can talk to on a phone. In England, it's the Samaritans. In Ireland, we have Citizens Advice. They put you onto a local group. I don't know what it would be in Italy or other countries, but find that particular organization that can help you. You don't need to be alone. Sometimes a person listening to you can stop the loneliness that you feel. I wish this for all of you. Take care for now.